观众朋友，傍晚好，欢迎收看《诗情有约》，我是梁权。
你好，我是有意。
李显龙总理和新内阁成员今天晚上7点呢将宣誓就职。
那么在今天的节目当中，我们会为您现场直播宣誓就职典礼的情况，请您锁定。
首先来关注今天的新闻内容，把时间交给主播王征。
谢谢梁权和有意，各位观众欢迎收看《诗情有约》的新闻部分，一起来了解这一段的重点内容。内阁宣誓仪式因为官病疫情的关系分两地举行，37名政治职务者将宣誓就职。李显龙总理和他的新内阁成员今天晚上7点将在总统府和国会大厦宣誓就职。由于我国目前仍然处于阻断措施解封第二阶段，就职典礼得要分两个地点举行，以保持安全距离。那么现在呢，就同位于总统府的记者洪宝玲来连线，请他告诉我们现场的情况。宝玲。
A 市的网征，那么在大约30分钟后呢，新内阁的就职典礼呢就将开始。而为了确保安全距离呢，这里呢就是让受邀宾客能够透过荧幕观礼的其中一个宴会厅。你也可以看到呢，就是他们的座位之间呢是隔开了1米的安全距离。李显龙总理和他的新内阁成员呢，今晚呢将在总统府和国会大厦两个地点同时宣誓就职。那么呢，这就是为了要确保他们可以保持一定的安全距离。那么哈利马总统呢将在总统府这里呢见证整个就职典礼，而这是哈利马总统呢首次见证就职典礼。那么在国会大厦那里呢，总统顾问理事会主席张赞成呢将会代表哈利马总统颁发委任书。那么哈利马总统和李总理呢也会在仪式上发表讲话。那么这一次的新内阁呢，共有37名政治职务者，和2015年大选后的人数是一样的。那么第四代领导班子的阵容呢，他们的职务呢是出现了不少的变化，当中呢就包括了担任5年教育部长的王以康将出任交通部长，教育部长呢则由卸下国家发展部长职务的黄循才出任，新当选议员陈诗龙呢则凭着丰富的私人领域经验一举入阁，受委担任总理公署部长和人力部兼交通和贸工部第二部长。那么李总理呢，前天在宣布新的内阁名单时呢，就表示了官兵疫情当前，领导团队的延续性，年轻部长的经验积累呢，以及这些内阁成员的更新呢，是这次内阁改组的3个主要考量。那么我们将在稍后的诗情有约节目中呢，为你直播就职典礼。把时间先交回给王征。
好，谢谢宝玲。刚刚是我们的记者宝玲从现场做的报道。现在把时间交给梁权和有意。
好的，谢谢王征。
好，今天晚上呢，新内阁的宣誓就职典礼即将在7点举行。
广告过后回来呢，我们将带你去观看宣誓就职典礼的现场情况，敬请锁定。
好，欢迎回到我们的节目现场。
没错，我国新内阁的宣誓仪式呢，目前正在进行当中。那么因为官病疫情的关系呢，这一次的宣誓仪式在总统府和国会大厦两个地点举行。宣誓仪式呢，是由哈利马总统见证，这是他第一次以总统的身份见证内阁就职典礼。
那我们现在呢，马上在画面上带大家到宣誓仪式的现场。接下来在画面上面，大家就是在这里看到的，这是受邀的宾客，他们可以通过荧幕观礼的其中一个宴会厅。那现场其实可以看到说，这个座位跟座位之间其实都隔开了最起码有1米的距离。
没错，那么。目前我们看到的画面呢，是从国会大厦所现场直播的画面。
是的，其实这一次李显龙总理和他的新内阁成员其实是在总统府，还有就是在这里国会大厦两个不同的地点同时的进行宣誓就职。那么哈利马总统呢，在这个总统府这一头呢见证整个就职典礼。接下来画面我们马上回到在总统府现场的情况。
目前我们在现场呢看到的有，好，目前看到的是李显龙总理已经步入了会场，以及他的夫人，总理夫人。
好，当然接下来很快呢，在现场就要进行新内阁宣誓就职典礼的直播。必须要说，其实这个2020年哦，对于世界各国来说，都将会是充满挑战的一年。也就是说呢，我们现在的新内阁成员，每一个人都可以说是身负重任。
没错，李总理在宣布新内阁的记者会上呢，时就表示哦，他尽量把新人引入这一届的内阁，让他们能够接触内阁的工作，也同时呢，跟资深的部长学习。过了一段时间之后呢，就能够成功的接过责任。
是，我想大家都记得，我们是在7月10号进行了投票的。那么是在刚刚过去的星期六，也就是7月25号的时候，宣布了新的内阁阵容。那么这次呢，担任政治职务者一共有37人，整体全员的平均年龄是52岁。
没错，那么现在我们在画面上呢看到的是我们的副总理王瑞杰。另外呢，还有我们现在看到的是在国会大厦的现场啊。另外在他身旁的还有我们现在看到的这位呢，也是国务资政尚塔曼。
好，我想其实大家也都知道，这是有史以来第一次哦。相信也是因为疫情的关系，这次的宣誓典礼必须要分开在两个不同的地点进行。
没错，在国会大厦内里呢，总统顾问理事会主席张赞成呢将会代表哈里马总统呢颁发委任书。
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mohammed Abdullah Al-Habshi.
目前我们在画面上看到的是哈里马总统夫婿到场。
其实可以想象，今天所有在现场的嘉宾大家的心情，我相信其实今天大家也都是带着挺严肃的心情到场，因为毕竟在接下来这批新内阁的成员即将呢要为我们这个2020年哦扛下这个相当不容易的重任，因为不管是在经济方面，在民生方面，都会充满各种各样的挑战。
没错，而且在场的各位都是要保持这个安全距离措施，同时也要戴上这个口罩。好，目前我们在画面上看到的有外交部长维稳医生，以及他们的夫人也到了现场。
好，我们现在在画面上呢也看到了总理李显龙，以及呢在他身边的这位就是大法官梅达善。
当然坐在他身后的还有荣誉国资政吴作栋。我们说在我们也看到了前总统陈庆炎，另外看到人力部长杨立明，以及后任的教育部长黄循财，以及通讯及新闻部长易华人。我们这一次的16个政府部门当中，有9个呢是保留了原部长。那么除了财政部之外呢，还包括了站在官兵前线的卫生部、贸工部和人力部。
Ladies and gentlemen, the President.
好，现在呢，在现场哈里马总统隆重入场。
我们新加坡第八任总统哈里马总统呢，是在2017年9月上任的，他也是我国的第一位女总统。
是，那么接下来呢，今天他会颁发委任书，而同时呢，和李显龙总理都会在仪式上发表讲话。
在奏完国歌过后呢，宣誓就职仪式呢，很快即将开始。
Ladies and gentlemen, the President will now deliver her speech.
Prime Minister, Cabinet Ministers, ladies and gentlemen, just 6 months ago, it was a very different world. In Singapore, we were advancing steadily on the course we had set over many years to develop our country, upgrading our economy and our workforce, developing our physical infrastructure, strengthening our social safety nets, fulfilling the aspirations of our people, and ensuring that Singapore remains a land of opportunity where every Singaporean who works hard can make good for themselves. At the same time, we watch with growing concern some developments in other countries. Globalization and free trade were in retreat. Geopolitical tensions were rising between the big powers. Many societies around the world were under stress, with their peoples angry and frustrated about their lives, and this sentiment fueling a wave of nativism and protectionism. These winds of unhappiness were erupting in various forms, be it Brexit in the UK, the yellow vests in France, or the drastic loss of support for moderate political leaders in the US, Europe, and elsewhere. Singapore, being a highly open society, was exposed to these same pressures. But fortunately, we were coping better than most because our people were united and our government focused on addressing our people's concerns and improving their lives. In the last 5 years, we have made significant progress. On the economic front, we strengthened Singapore's competitiveness. The Future Economy Council, chaired by DPM Heng Swee Keat, led the effort to transform our industries, to prepare them for the future, and retrain our workforce to stay productive and employable. We also strengthened our social compact. The government made major investments and policy reforms to improve people's lives and prospects, and to make the basic needs of life more affordable and accessible. We enabled young Singaporeans to buy HDB flats earlier to start their families. We invested heavily in preschools and enhanced preschool subsidies to give every child a good start in life. We give our people peace of mind on healthcare costs, particularly our elderly, through the Pioneer Generation Package and Merdeka Generation Package and schemes like MediShield Life and CareShield Life. And we supported Singaporeans in their lifelong learning journeys through Skills Future and continuing education. To support those who need extra help, the government enhanced silver support, workfare, and Comcare, and improved social service delivery on the ground. Singaporeans from all walks of life stepped forward to partner the government in all these efforts through the SG Together movement to create a shared future where every Singaporean had a stake, and to build a fair and just society with opportunities for all. Then suddenly this year, with COVID-19, we found ourselves in a crisis of a generation. It is an upheaval that could derail our course and set back Singapore for many years. Our progress in the last 5 years and over many years before that has given us a strong base to work from. Even so, we have had to master all our strength and our resources to mount an emergency response to this overwhelming challenge. Over the last 6 months, the government has been totally occupied with the COVID-19 outbreak and its economic fallout. We hugely expanded our medical facilities to treat COVID-19 cases. We introduced rigorous safe distancing measures, scaled up testing and contact tracing, and implemented the circuit breaker to slow down transmission of the virus. We launched a massive and complex operation to bring the outbreak in the migrant worker dormitories under control and keep both the migrant workers and Singaporeans safe. To cushion the impact of the outbreak on our jobs and income, the Minister for Finance introduced 4 budgets in quick succession, injecting close to $100 billion. The government sought my permission to draw more than half of this from the past reserves. Having consulted the Council of Presidential Advisors and considered the request carefully, I approved the draw on reserves and gave the government my full support. I concurred with its assessment that we needed to bring all our resources to bear to deal with this existential challenge, the most serious since our nation's independence, and protect Singaporeans' lives and livelihoods. After 6 months of unremitting effort and the tireless work of our frontline heroes, we have stabilized our situation in Singapore. But the crisis is far from over. The government called a general election to secure a fresh mandate and a new full term in order to make the necessary and difficult decisions to deal with the troubled times ahead. Now that the election is over, we must focus on the challenges and the agenda ahead. If anything good has come out of the COVID-19 pandemic, it is the reaffirmation of our Singapore spirit. Our resilience as one people has brought us through this crisis so far. I am heartened by the way Singaporeans from all walks of life have collectively mobilized resources to help one another in this most difficult of times. I am proud of how we have stood together in solidarity with one another. So for this next phase, I ask Singaporeans to similarly unite behind the government that we have elected and give it our full support to see Singapore through this crisis. Prime Minister, I have confidence that you and your team will steer Singapore safely through these tumultuous times so that we can resume our journey to build a better future for ourselves. Ladies and gentlemen, I now ask Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong to come forward to take his affirmations of allegiance and for due execution of office, followed by the ministers he has designated as members of his cabinet.
以上呢就是哈利马总统在新内阁的宣誓仪式所发表的讲话。
是的，其实总统也提到呢，我们在这次冠病疫情下呢，政府其实拨出了4次不同的预算案来帮助国人呢保生计、保饭碗，度过这个难关。
是，接下来马上由李总理来发表讲话。And for due execution of office.
Now, we 看到步上台的是大法官梅达顺。
The affirmation of allegiance.
I, Lee Hsien Loong, having been appointed to the office of Prime Minister.Do solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The affirmation for due execution of office.
I, Lee Hsien Loong, being chosen and appointed as Prime Minister of Singapore, do solemnly affirm that I will at all times faithfully discharge my duties as Prime Minister.According to law and to the best of my knowledge and ability, without fear or favor, affection or ill will.
signing of the affirmations.
李显龙总理的政治生涯呢，是在1980年代开始的。在1984年的时候呢，首次当选为德意选区的国会议员。那么在刚今年7月10号举行的国会选举呢，是李显龙总理呢第9次当选。
李显龙总理7月25号的时候公布新的那个名单，一共有37人受委政治职务，在16个部门当中呢，有6个部门更换部长，而有6名新人受委政治职务。
那么在总理宣誓就职之后呢，很快将会率领他的内阁团队宣誓就职。
In accordance with Article 25(1) of the Constitution, I hereby appoint Mr. Lee Hsien Loong as Prime Minister of the Republic of Singapore.
Presentation of Instrument of Appointment.
总统正式宣布李显龙总理并把颁发委任状，
并且呢由大法官雷达顺见证这个过程。
In
accordance with legal requirements, appointees at the Parliament House are kindly reminded to show the President the written oaths and affirmations through the camera before and after signing. Appointment and swearing in of the Deputy Prime Minister, Coordinating Minister for Economic Policies, and Minister for Finance.
现在要进行宣誓就职的是副总理兼财政部长王瑞杰。
The Chief Justice will now lead in the swearing in.
接下来由大法官梅达顺。
The affirmation of allegiance.
I, having been appointed to the office of Minister.
I, Heng Swee Keat, having been appointed to the office of Minister.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore.
And that I will preserve.
And that I will preserve.
Protect and defend.
Protect and defend.
The Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The affirmation for due execution of office.
I, being chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore,
I, Heng Swee Keat, having been chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore,
do solemnly affirm that I will at all times faithfully discharge my duties as Minister according to law, and to the best of my knowledge and ability, without fear or favor, affection or ill will.
Signing of the affirmations.
使其在这次的新内阁当中呢，是王瑞杰保留了原有的职务，并且额外的受委为经济政策统筹部长。
没错。是在这次的新内阁当中呢，王瑞杰是保留了原有的职务嘛，就像你刚才所说的，还额外受委为经济政策统筹部长。
As advised by the Prime Minister and pursuant to Article 25(1) of the Constitution, I hereby appoint the person before me as a Minister of the Republic of Singapore.
Presentation of instrument of appointment by the Chairman of the Council of Presidential Advisors on behalf of the President. Mr. Heng Swee Keat, Deputy Prime Minister, Coordinating Minister for Economic Policies and Minister for Finance.
好，现在呢，副总理王瑞杰接受委任状。其实，在宣布新内阁的记者会上，其实他也提到了说，我国接下来会面临严峻的经济环境，当务之急就是要帮助员工们保住饭碗。
那么王瑞杰是在2018年底呢出任人民行动党的第一助理秘书长，去年五月升任副总理。
他也是第四代领导班子之首，目前也是内阁唯一的副总理。
The Chief Justice will now lead in the swearing in.
I, having been appointed to the office of Minister,
I, Liu Qijian, having been appointed to the office of Minister,
do solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore,
that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore,
and that I will preserve, protect and defend the Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The affirmation for due execution of office.
I, being chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore,
I, Teo Chee Hien, being chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore,
do solemnly affirm,That I will at all times faithfully discharge my duties as minister according to law, and to the best of my knowledge and ability, without fear or favor, affection or ill will.
Signing of the affirmations.
刚刚我们看到呢，就是由大法官梅达顺为国务资政兼国家安全统筹部长张志贤进行宣誓就职。
那么，张志贤与尚达曼，我们两位国务资政都是在2019年5月1号卸下了副总理职务的，之后受委为国务资政，并且留在内阁服务。
By the Prime Minister.And pursuant to Article 25(1) of the Constitution, I hereby appoint the person before me as a Minister of the Republic of Singapore.
Presentation of instrument of appointment by the Chairman of the Council of Presidential Advisors on behalf of the President. Mr. Teo Chee Hien, Senior Minister and Coordinating Minister for National Security.
接下来，国务资政兼国家安全统筹部长张志贤将接过委任书。
接下来呢，国务资政兼社会政策统筹部长尚达曼将进行宣誓。
Chief Justice will now lead in the swearing in.
I, having been appointed to the office of Minister,
I, Tharmachorn Vigarantham, having been appointed to the office of Minister,
do solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Singapore.
And that I will preserve. Protect and defend. The Constitution of the Republic of Singapore.
The affirmation for due execution of office.
I, being chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore.
I, Tharmachorn Vigarantham, being chosen and appointed as Minister of Singapore,
do solemnly affirm that I will at all times faithfully discharge my duties as Minister according to law, and to the best of my knowledge and ability, without fear or favor, affection or ill will.
Signing of the affirmations.
as advised by the Prime Minister, and pursuant to Article 25(1) of the Constitution, I hereby appoint the person before me as Minister of the Republic of Singapore.
这是哈里马总统正式宣布上达曼，正式成为国务资政兼社会政策统筹部长。Mr.
Tharman Shanmugaratnam, Senior Minister and Coordinating Minister for Social Policies.
<音>好，那现在呢，现场的仪式依旧在进行当中。没错，那么以上呢是我们新内阁宣誓就职典礼的现场情况。稍后的晚间新闻呢，我们会有更多的内阁宣誓的报道。
那么今天的狮城有约就为您进行到这里，感谢您的收看，我们与您再会，
再见。